Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I am your educator, Dr. Lara Munir, and the topic of discussion today is syncope. As we know that syncope is a very extensive topic and it involves multi-system, so we are going to have a multi-system approach to this syncope topic. And I will try my best to explain the various types of syncope and how we are going to manage this condition. We're going to start off by defining syncope. What is the classical definition? What are the various criteria the syncope must meet to arrive at a diagnosis of syncope? Then afterwards, we are going to classify the various types of syncope. What are the various different types involving the nervous system or the cardiac symptoms? To elaborate the classification further, we are going to look at the subtypes of the various classification. For example, what are the various types of neurally mediated syncope, or what are the various cardiac causes of syncope? The pathophysiology in the background of the baroreceptor reflex will be discussed. We are going to revise our baroreceptor reflex physiology. And then after the revision, we are going to look at what is going wrong in the person that can lead to their transient loss of consciousness or the syncope in a patient. Similarly, certain high-risk features or high-risk symptoms which need further evaluation or which need the patient to be admitted to the hospital are going to be discussed in detail. They primarily involve the heart, and then we elaborate. These symptoms are very important to understand because our management of the patient changes if these symptoms are present. Similarly, the pathophysiology of the neurally mediated syncope will be discussed. We are going to, in a stepwise manner, move from the most common cause, neurally mediated syncope, to the other causes, the orthostatic hypotension or the cardiac syncope. In orthostatic hypotension, first, what is the criteria of orthostatic hypotension? What is the classic definition of this abnormality? What can be the various abnormalities that can lead to orthostatic hypotension, and how do we treat this pathology? Similarly, what can go wrong at the level of the heart in a patient that can cause cardiac sympathy? We are going to discuss the pathophysiology, what causes the bradycardia, what leads to a decrease in the cardiac output that can lead to a global interruption of the cerebral blood supply. And at the end of the lecture, with the help of a very neat and a very descriptive flowchart, we are going to stepwise go to rule out the other causes of syncope. To first arrive at a diagnosis of syncope, and then when we have confirmed that this patient has syncope, what can be the various underlying causes of this syncope based on the different types. We are going to stepwise rule out the various types, and then with the help of certain investigations which are needed, with the help of certain tests which are very specific to certain conditions, we are going to arrive at our definitive diagnosis so that we can educate the patient about their problem and provide them reassurance, and if needed, provide them with certain pharmacologic interventions or therapy. So, to watch this complete lecture and along with it thousands of other medical lectures on any area of your interest, be it the basic sciences like the anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, or the clinical side, the surgery, gyne obs, or medicine, log on to sqadia.com and start your free trial today.